Back 617, if you've lived in Anchorage for any amount of time, you've likely enjoyed the trail system here.
Maybe you like to jog or bike the trails during the summer or do a little cross-country skiing in the winter months.
This morning, as part of my series on Nordic skiing, we're meeting three of the people responsible for helping build those trails, getting a little history lesson on how the Nordic Ski Club got its start in Anchorage. On any given winter day, you might find Jim Burkholder out skiing the trails at Kincaid Park. Burkholder has a history with these trails because he helped build them.
We needed to look for a public land, i.e. parkland, where we could develop a trail to ski on.
The trails that Nordic Ski Club built were incredible trails.
Burkholder, along with Lynn Henderman and Richard Mize, are all former Anchorage ski coaches.
We didn't have any trails to ski on, so our technique practice was out away from the parking lot, around the hockey rink, and then back.
When they first arrived in Anchorage in the 1950s, the only option was to ski at Arctic Valley or make do somewhere else.
And what we ended up skiing on that first winter was the fence line that the airport had put up as a security fence to keep mainly the wildlife critters like moose off the runway.
So the three of them, along with a group of dedicated parents, decided to build trails at local high schools so that students had somewhere to ski.
It had a great vision to start with. Tons of volunteers that shared sort of the love of the outdoors and wanting their kids to be active.
The first trails were built for East High at Russian Jack Springs, where Mize was the ski coach.
The way we groom trails is we'd have a couple of people on snowshoes that would go around the trail. We'd have the other team members sidestepping the trail. Then we'd have a couple more people in the back putting the tracks in. So there's a great deal of effort, you know, to get a 5-kilometer trail packed and ready to go.
Today, all but two Anchorage high schools have direct access to the trail system.
As we developed these high school skiers, they became interested in going off to college, and then they wanted to try to make an Olympic team. To do that, we knew we had to have the trail system developed. And the only way we were going to get it was do it ourselves.
That group of volunteers became known as the Nordic Ski Club and eventually the Nordic Skiing Association of Anchorage.
Without Nordic Ski Club, we wouldn't have seen a Keegan Randall or a James Southam. All of those kids might never have had the opportunities. They might have, but the program was in place for them to just move right up.
Since then, they've continued to expand and maintain Anchorage's trail system for everyone to enjoy.
So is the Mize Loop Trail named after you?
Yeah.
How does that feel?
Well, proud of that too, yeah.
Anchorage is an urban area of 300,000 people. Has probably better access to skiing right out a person's door than almost any place that I can think of.
Well, NSAA has grown from just a couple hundred members back when it first started to about 2,000 today. That membership, of course, supports the maintenance of all those trails year-round, summer and winter. Plus, members get to participate in those really cool events like the Ski Train to Curry and Ski
say.
For Kids. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and those are both coming up. So we'll have info on how you can become a member, KTVA.com.
Very humble. Having a trail named after him.
Yeah.
It's nice.
And those three are all, some of them are former Olympic athletes, Olympic coaches. Their bios are awesome, and they're all in the cross-country ski hall of fame as well.
A richer history than we probably realized.
Yeah, there was a lot that went into it. Lots of really cool stuff.
All right.